بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، وصلى الله على محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. In the name of Allah, the most beneficent, the most merciful, I testify that there is no true God worthy of worship except Allah, and that Muhammad is Allah's true slave and messenger. We continue the explanation on the three fundamental principles of Islam, and we have reached the point where the author, may Allah's mercy be upon him, said, اعلم أرشدك الله لطاعته أن الحنيفية ملة إبراهيم أن تعبد الله وحده مخلصا له الدين. No, may Allah direct you, أرشدك الله, may Allah direct you to his obedience or to obedience to him, that أن الحنيفية ملة إبراهيم, that the true and straight religion is the way of Ibrahim. First explanation of these words, اعلم, and this concerns knowledge and the importance of knowledge, and the explanation and the importance of knowledge already preceded. Now the second is, he said أرشدك الله. أرشدك, this is from الرشد, which means this is an invocation. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala direct you and guide you to uprightness on the way of the truth, on the way of the truth. This is الرشد, this is the meaning of الرشد. So الرشد is uprightness on the path of the truth, and this is the opposite of the path of misguidance. And the path of misguidance leads to loss in this life and in the hereafter. Then he said, أرشدك الله لطاعته, may Allah direct you up to uprightness upon the way of truth. لطاعته, to his obedience. And the meaning of obedience is to comply with the command that came in the Sharia in Islam by executing the command of Allah, doing what Allah wants the believer to do, واجتناب المحظور, and to abstain from what he forbade, what he forbade and what is forbidden. So he said, no, may Allah direct you to obedience to him. أن الحنيفية, that the حنيفية. What is the حنيفية? الحنيفية is the religion which is sincere and pure to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, free from shirk. So it is founded upon sincerity and purity of intention, seeking Allah alone. And الحنيفية is the root of it, which is derived from الحنف. Is derived from al-hanaf, and al-hanaf means inclination, al-mail. So al-hanif, the one who is hanif, is the one who is inclined away from shirk towards tawheed, inclined away from shirk and in the direction of tawheed, singling Allah alone in worship. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in fact, described Ibrahim as such in Surah An-Nahl, chapter 16, verse 120. قال الله تعالى إن إبراهيم كان أمة قانتا لله حنيفا. إن إبراهيم كان أمة قانتا لله حنيفا. فلل إبراهيم was an ummah, a leader, obedient to Allah, حنيفة, sincerely worshipping none but Allah. And here, back to the words of the author, when he said, no, may Allah direct you to obedience to him, and that the true straight religion, the way of Ibrahim, ملة إبراهيم, ملة means the way, in this case it means the deen of Ibrahim. And the millah covers all that which Allah prescribed to his slaves on the tongue of his prophets and messengers, on the tongue of his prophets and messengers. And therefore in this case it will be the way, the deen of Ibrahim alayhi salam. And Ibrahim is the chosen and beloved friend, al-Khalil, Khalil al-Rahman. Khalil al-Rahman means, al-Khalil means the chosen and beloved friend of Ar-Rahman, of the most many, of the most merciful. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described him as such in the Noble Quran in Surah An-Nisa in chapter 4 verse 125. Allah the Most High said, وَاتَّخَذَ اللَّهُ إِبْرَاهِيمَ خَلِيلًا وَاتَّخَذَ اللَّهُ إِبْرَاهِيمَ خَلِيلًا. And Allah made Ibrahim a chosen and beloved friend. A chosen and beloved friend. So what is the millah of Ibrahim? The millah of Ibrahim is to worship none but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the deen. And that's why the author said, no, may Allah direct you to obedience to him, that the true and straight religion, the way of Ibrahim, the way of Ibrahim is, and he defined it, is أن تعبد الله وحده مخلصا له الدين, that you worship Allah alone, making the deen purely and sincerely for Allah, for him. Is that you worship Allah alone, making the deen, the religion, purely and sincerely for Allah alone. This is the millah. This is therefore the millah, the deen of Ibrahim. This is the deen of Ibrahim. This is the way of Ibrahim. And here the author said is that you worship Allah alone. What is the meaning of worship in Islam? What is the meaning of worship in Islam? The origin of the term worship is in Arabic called al-ibadah. The origin and the general meaning therefore is submitting and yielding, and submitting and yielding with love and awe, with love and awe. Submitting oneself to Allah with love and awe, and this means we do that which Allah had ordered, and we avoid that which he has forbidden in the manner, in the way which Allah prescribed, in the manner which Allah prescribed. This is the general meaning. This is the general meaning of the word al-ibadah in Islam, worship in Islam. As to the particular meaning, this is the meaning which is related to what it entails. The particular meaning is related to what it entails. And this is the meaning which is defined, which is as Shaykh al-Islam Ibn Taymiyyah, may Allah's mercy be upon him, defined it as ismun al-ibadah, as al-ibadah is ismun jami'un likulli ما يحبه الله ويرضى من الأقوال والأعمال الظاهرة والباطنة. The particular meaning of worship in Islam is that it is a comprehensive term covering whatever Allah loves and is pleased with, both sayings and actions, the apparent and the hidden, such as fearing, having awe, salah, doing salah, performing salah, giving zakah, fasting, and other practices or matters prescribed by Allah. This is the general meaning. This is the specific meaning of ibadah. So it covers everything that Allah loves and is pleased with, both sayings and actions, apparent and hidden. The apparent is known, like salah, zakah, fasting, hajj, and the hidden is the actions and the sayings of the heart, like love, al-mahabba, khawf, fear, raja, hope, tawakkul, dependence, isti'ana, seeking help, استغاثة, seeking refuge, and the like. All these are from the hidden, pertaining to the heart, pertaining to the heart. So here, therefore, the milla, the deen of Ibrahim, is to worship. And now we know what is the meaning of worship in Islam, that it is of two types, general and particular, general and specific. And then, is this enough? أن تعبد الله وحده, you worship Allah alone, but with the condition, مخلصا له الدين. مخلصا له الدين, meaning you worship him with purity and sincerity of worship being done only for the desiring the face of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and to reach the place where Allah bestows upon bestows honor and favors, meaning paradise. So this is the meaning of ikhlas. This is the meaning of ikhlas. So the person desires the face of Allah, the mighty and majestic, desires in his actions and his sayings the face of Allah and his reward. Not desiring, of course, desiring not any kind of prestige or leadership or anything of the matters of this life, which will come to an end. So, if the person executes the worship and performs the worship seeking Allah and His pleasure, knowing that Allah alone deserves to be worshipped, and also hoping for the reward from Allah, this manifests al-ikhlas. This manifests al-ikhlas, sincerity. So the person therefore desires the face of Allah by his worship, intends and desires the face of Allah, the mighty and majestic, and to reach the place where he bestows honor and favor, meaning paradise. And therefore, the person does not worship anything along with Allah, neither an angel brought near, nor any prophet sent as a messenger. Now, that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah An-Nahl, in chapter 16, verse 123, concerning the millah, the way of Ibrahim, that it was pure worship of Allah, he said, ثم أوحينا إليك أن اتبع ملة إبراهيم حنيفا وما كان من المشركين. Then we have inspired you, O Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, follow the religion of Ibrahim حنيفا. We know now what is حنيفا means, upright on the religion, sincere, worship none but Allah. And he was not of the mushriks. Ibrahim عليه السلام was not of the mushriks, was not of the polytheists or idolaters or disbelievers. So therefore, in sincerity, we seek Allah's face and we seek the reward from Him. It is blameworthy from the slave to worship Allah not seeking the reward of Allah. This is one of the ways of Sufism and mysticism. And this is in opposition to all the evidences in the authentic texts that the person seeks and desires Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and also desires the attaining of Allah's rewards and pleasure and His paradise. And sincerity has a lot of benefits from that. It perfects the worship and takes away from the heart of the believer any kind of inclination to other than Allah. Secondly, the person, the sincere person in his worship of Allah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will drive away sins and disobedience of him. as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in Surah Yusuf in chapter 12 concerning Prophet Yusuf alayhi salam 12:24. قال الله عز وجل كذلك لنصرف عنه السوء والفحشاء إنه من عبادنا المخلصين. And indeed, then we have inspired you, O Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. كذلك لنصرف عنه السوء. Thus it was that we might turn away from him, from Joseph, evil and illegal sexual intercourse. Surely he was one of our chosen guided slaves. Allah chose him and guided him because he was sincere in worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Also from the benefits is the one who is sincere in his worship, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protects him from shaitan. Allah protects him from shaitan. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala stated in Surah Al-Hijr, verse 42, قال الله تعالى إِنَّ عِبَادِي لَيْسَ لَكَ عَلَيْهِمْ سُلْطَانٍ إِنَّ عِبَادِي لَيْسَ لَكَ عَلَيْهِمْ سُلْطَانٍ. Certainly you shall have no authority over my slaves. Addressing Shaitan, Satan. Certainly you shall have no authority over my slaves, except those who follow you from the mushriks and those who go astray from the criminals, the politicians and the evildoers. Also, we know that Shaitan made it also clear that in Surah Al-Isra, chapter 17, verse 65, that there was an exception. Let's go over this verse. قال الشيطان here فبعزتك لأغوينهم أجمعين. Verily, فبعزتك لأغوينهم أجمعين إلا عبادك منهم المخلصين. إلا عبادك منهم المخلصين. سورة صاد 38 verses 82-83. فبعزتك لأغوينهم أجمعين إلا عبادك المخلصين. Iblis said, by your might, then I will surely mislead them all except إلا عبادك منهم المخلصين, except your chosen slaves amongst them. These are the faithful and the ones who were sincere in singling Allah alone in worship. Also we know from the benefits of sincerity, from the hadith of Utban, may Allah be pleased with him, that he said, that the Prophet ﷺ said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ حَرَّمَ عَلَى النَّارِ, Allah forbade for the fire, مَنْ قَالَ, the one who says, لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ, the one who says, there is no true God worthy of worship except Allah, يَبْتَغِي بِذَلِكَ وَجْهَ اللَّهِ, seeking in that the face, or desires in that the face of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then the author, rahimahullah, gave the proof for what he stated earlier in brevity, he said, nor may Allah direct you to obedience to him, that the true and straight religion, the way of Ibrahim, is that you worship Allah alone, making the religion purely and sincerely for him. He said, بِذَٰلِكَ أَمَرَ اللَّهُ جَمِيعَ النَّاسِ وَخَلَقَهُمْ لَهَا. This is what Allah commanded all of the people with. And it was for this purpose, to worship him alone, that he created them. That he created them. Making all the religion sincere and purely for him. This is what Allah commanded all of creation with, and it was for this that he created them. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in this regard, وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ In 51, in Surah Al-Dhariyat 51-56, this is the purpose of our creation. I didn't create jinn and mankind except that they should worship me. This great verse clarifies the great wisdom behind the creation of the jinn and mankind. And the jinn are creatures from the unseen world, established creatures, different from mankind, because even in their form of creation, they are created from fire and mankind from clay. This is what Allah stated about them in Surah Al-Rahman, chapter 55, verses 14-15 concerning the nature of creation of mankind and jinn. Allah Ta'ala خَلَقَ الْإِنسَانَ مِنْ صَلْصَالٍ كَالْفَخَّارِ وَخَلَقَ الْجَانَّ مِنْ مَارِجٍ مِنْ نَارِ. He created man, Adam, from sounding clay, like the clay of pottery. وَخَلَقَ الْجَانَّ And the jinns did he create from a smokeless flame of fire. They were called jinn because of their ijtinan, which means being hidden, unseen by the eyes, by the sight. Allah stated in Surah Al-A'raf in chapter 7, verse 27, إِنَّهُ يَرَاكُمْ هُوَ وَقَبِيلُهُ مِنْ حَيْثُ لَا تَرَوْنَهُمْ إِنَّهُ يَرَاكُمْ هُوَ وَقَبِيلُهُ مِنْ حَيْثُ لَا تَرَوْنَهُمْ Verily he and his soldiers, Iblis and his soldiers from the jinns and his tribe, see you from where you can't see them. And as to al-ins, which means mankind, al-bashar, humans, the single is insi. They were called because of the familiarity which goes between them and the acquaintances which goes between them, and also because of tranquility that goes between them. They are called, the individual is called insi, and al-ins meaning the human kind. So what is the purpose therefore? What is the evidence? This is the great verse. I didn't create jinn and mankind except that they should worship me. And then he said, وَمَعْنَى يَعْبُدُونَ And the meaning of worship in this verse is يُوَحِّدُونَ I created not the jinns and men except that they should worship me يعبدون which means يوحدون meaning that توحيد is from the meaning of worship توحيد singling Allah alone in worship is from the meaning of عبادة that is true worship which to make is to make all of it purely for Allah this is توحيد It's true worship which is to make all of it purely for Allah. So this is the great task on mankind and jinn to worship Allah, the Most High, having all of the worship purely for him. This is the meaning of Tawheed. And the term Tawheed in the language, linguistically, this is a verbal noun derived from the verb وَحَّدَ يُوَحِّدُ meaning unify something and make it one to unify something and make it one And this Tawheed can be realized through two matters. The first is called denial. In Arabic it is called Nafi. And the second is called affirmation. And in Arabic it means Ithbat. So it is to be realized through Nafi, denial, and Ithbat, affirmation. Denial of this ruling for anything other than that which is made for. That there is no true deity. Affirmation for him alone. That there is no true deity worthy of worship, this is denial. An affirmation for him, Allah alone. So a person's tawheed is not complete until he bears witness that none has the right to be worshipped except Allah. So therefore he must deny the right to be worshipped for everything besides Allah, and he must affirm that for Allah alone. He must affirm the worship for Allah alone. So we don't worship any prophet sent by Allah, nor any of the creation. Neither any angel brought near. And nor, of course, neither also any righteous man, present or absent. Rather, the believer singles Allah alone with all worship out of love, veneration, longing, and awe. Singling Allah alone with all worship out of love, veneration, longing, and awe. This is the Tawheed. This is the meaning of Tawheed. And there is a more general definition. There is a more general definition of it. And and it is singling out Allah, the most perfect, with all that is particular to him. Singling out Allah, the most perfect, with all that is particular to him. And the branches of Tawheed are three. The branches of Tawheed are three. First is Tawheed of Allah's Lordship, which is known in Arabic as Tawheed al-Rububiyyah. Tawheed al-Rububiyyah. And this means to single out Allah with creation, meaning the creation is His, sovereignty or authority, and control of the affairs and also the kingdom. To single Allah alone with creation, sovereignty, and control of the affairs and of the kingdom. The kingdom is His. The evidences of this are numerous in the Noble Quran and in the authentic Sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. In the Quran, for example, Allah states in Surah Az-Zumar, in chapter 39, verse 62, قال الله تعالى الله خالق كل شيء. Allah is the creator of everything. And in Surah Fatir, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Fatir 35:3, هل من خالق غير الله يرزقكم من السماء والأرض؟ لا إله إلا هو فأنا تؤفكون. Is there any creator besides Allah providing you with provision from the heavens, from the sky, from the rain and the earth? لا إله إلا هو, none has the right to be worshipped but He. How then are you turning away from Him? Meaning, since He is the creator, therefore He deserves to be worshipped alone. And that the dominion is His, the evidence for this is in Surah Al-Mulk, chapter 67, verse 1. قال الله تعالى تبارك الذي بيده الملك وهو على كل شيء قدير. Exalted is He in whose hand is the dominion of everything, and He is able to do all things. And also the command is His, as Allah states in Surah Al-A'raf, chapter 7, verse 54, أَلَا لَهُ الْخَلْقُ وَالْأَمْرُ تَبَارَكَ اللَّهُ رَبُّ الْعَالَمِينَ. Indeed, creation and the command are His. Blessed is Allah, exalted is Allah, the Lord of all creation. The Lord of all creation. This is the meaning of Lordship, Tawheed of Lordship. Or in Arabic is Tawheed al-Rububiyyah. Al-Rububiyyah comes from Al-Rabb, that Allah is the true Lord. Second is the Tawheed of Worship. Second is Tawheed of Worship, or known as in Arabic Tawheed al-Uluhiyyah. Tawheed al-Uluhiyyah, Tawheed of Worship or Tawheed of Divinity, in Arabic called Tawheed al-Uluhiyyah. And this means to single Allah out, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one free of all imperfection and the most high, with all worship. To single Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with all worship, singling out with all worship. None to be taken as a rival to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So a person does not take anyone else besides Allah and worship him and do acts of devotion for him as he worships Allah and does acts of devotion for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is where this was the battleground between the messengers and their respective nations. This is what they called their people, and this is where they had a lot to face concerning the deviation from this great aspect of singling Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone in worship. And the third one is Tawheed of Allah's names and attributes. Tawheed of Allah's names and attributes. And this is known in Arabic as Tawheed al-Asma'i wa-Sifat. Tawheed al-Asma'i wa-Sifat. It means that we single Allah out with whatever names and attributes He has affirmed for Himself in His book or upon the tongue of His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So we affirm whatever Allah has affirmed for Himself, and we deny whatever He has denied from Himself without changing and distorting their meanings, without denying or divesting Allah of His attributes, without delving into how they are, and without declaring Allah to be like the creation. This is the meaning of Tawheed of Allah's names and attributes. In the words of the author here, he was focusing on the Tawheed of worship when he cited that this is the Millah, this is the Deen of Ibrahim, and that this was the command all people were commanded with, and it was for this that Allah created them to worship none but Him. And it is with regard to this matter that the mushriks went astray, those whom the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam fought, and whose blood wealth hands, lands and homes he had made lawful. Most of the striving of the messengers with their people was with regard to this category of Tawheed, as we mentioned earlier. And this is illustrated in the verse in Surah An-Nahl, chapter 16, verse 36. قال الله تعالى وَلَقَدْ بَعَثْنَا فِي كُلِّ أُمَّةٍ رَسُولًا أَنْ اعْبُدُوا اللَّهَ وَاجْتَنِبُوا الطَّاغُوتِ. Verily we have sent a messenger to every nation, commanding that they should worship Allah alone. So here, worship is not correct except for Allah. Worship is not correct except for Allah. So whoever claims that he worship Allah, that he worships Allah and takes him as his Lord and only true Lord, and he affirms to Allah the Tawheed of the names and attributes, but violates this Tawheed of worship, like he goes to a grave and directs worship to its occupant, or offers a sacrifice as an offering for the occupant, then he would be a mushrik, unbeliever. And if he dies on this, he will be an inhabitant of the hellfire. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes this clear in Surah Al-Ma'idah, chapter 5, verse 72. Chapter 5, verse 72. قال الله تعالى إنه من يشرك بالله فقد حرم الله عليه الجنة ومأواه النار وما للظالمين من أنصار. Indeed, whoever associates anything in worship with Allah, then Allah has forbidden paradise for him, and his abode will be the fire. And for the transgressors who worship others besides Allah, there will be no one to help and save them from Allah's punishment on the day of resurrection. There are no helpers for them. Tawheed, therefore, is the greatest command given by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is the foundation upon which the whole religion is built. All the prophets began with this, and our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam began with it in his call to Allah, and he ordered those whom he sent out as callers to begin also with it, the same matter of singling Allah alone in worship. And therefore this is the most important matter that the Muslim should focus upon in his life, singling Allah alone in worship. And this worship here refers to the legal worship, submitting to Allah's command, legal commands, carrying on and executing the responsibilities. As to the universal form of worship, which is called al-ibadah al-kawniyya, it means submitting to Allah's universal decree, submission to what Allah has commanded and decreed in creation. And this is general, it covers all the creation. No one. So this is the submission that is common to all of the creation. No being is able to escape it. No being is able to escape it. قال الله تعالى in Surah Maryam, chapter 19, verse 93. قال الله تعالى إن كل من في السماوات والأرض إلا آتي الرحمن عبدا. There is none in the heavens and the earth but comes unto Ar-Rahman, the most beneficent, on the day of resurrection as submissive slaves. It covers all the creation, believers and non-believers, righteous and wicked. And this is referring to what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala pre-decrees in the creation. Bringing to existence sickness, illness, poverty, loss of beloved ones and the like. All of these are universal decrees. And this type of submission is not something for which a servant is commended, since it is not due to any action of his own. However, he may be commended for giving thanks in times of ease and for having patience in times of trial. This is different from the legal worship, and that requires submission, for which a person is commended for the legal commands, submitting to the legal commands of Allah and abstaining from what He has forbidden. So this is the greatest matter which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had the greatest commandment given by Allah is Tawheed, since it is the foundation upon which the whole religion is built. That's why the author rahimahullah mentioned this. He said, وَأَعْظَمُ مَا أَمَرَ اللَّهُ التَّوْحِيدِ وَهُوَ إِفْرَادُ اللَّهِ بِالْعِبَادَةِ. And the greatest of all that Allah has commanded is Tawheed, which is to single out Allah with all worship, having that sincerely for His face and seeking His reward and paradise and His pleasure. This brings the end of this discussion, and in the next one inshallah ta'ala we'll talk about what is in what is the most serious thing that Allah has forbade, and that is shirk, which is to invoke others besides Allah along with Him and to ascribe partners with Him in worship. This is the most serious thing that He Allah forbid. This will be the topic of the next discussion. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to have mercy upon the Shaykh and also upon our Shaykh rahimahullah for the discussions of the this great book on the three fundamentals. والحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله على محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم.